What's going on, gamers? It's Dreamkillers representing Mad Mastermind. Hope everybody is doing well today. Let me know down in the comment section, man, if you guys had a good weekend, if you did anything fun and exciting. Wanted to start off by saying I apologize, number one, for only having one video today. Number two, for reposting a game that I guess I previously posted sometime this week, man. I had a bunch sitting on top of my desktop. And there's no excuses, man. I guess I should know. But I was doing a pretty good job organizing the games in line with my edits and stuff like that. But for some reason, that one slipped through the cracks. So I apologize. Hopefully none of these ones. Like, this game didn't look familiar when I was chopping up, and neither did the other one. I think sometimes I just get in the zone when I'm editing. So I apologize, man. I appreciate you guys still leaving likes and whatnot on that and helping me catch that mistake, man. I do apologize. This game here, we are controlling the San Francisco 49ers squad. Our opponent is controlling the Giants squad, and we are playing terrible in this game. Not to discredit the opponent, who is doing very well pretty much on both sides of the ball. I was not, you know, making any smart reads. He was stopping the run up pretty well. So I was struggling, needless to say. So Jerry Rice can't even hang on to it on third down. So we got to settle for the field goal. We are West Coast and on offense. Blueprint defense, I don't know if we're West Coast, then, though. We are running West Coast. We do send the heat, though, man. This is one of those games, man, when your defense has to step up and keep you in the game. If you guys don't have a Jack Ham yet, I would say he's probably the MVP of Mutts. From what I've seen, man, he makes plays against me. He makes plays for me. Definitely does his thing. So, fortunately, we were able to stop him and able to kick a field goal after he punts there right before halftime. So, that may turn out to be big here. You can see this is a close game. Really comes down to the last possession. So, definitely stick tuned here for the next couple minutes. In the background, we have Ninth Wonder, as usual. And I'm going to try to get a new slew of beats this week and try to throw them through the... I know some people that have watched all the videos probably heard this one before, but it's on the Blady May beat tape that he has. It's literally 70 instrumentals, man. For 10 bucks, I think it's probably one of the best values out there. Literally hit play and then just chill for the next hour or however long the beat tape is. Some of the tracks are only like 30 seconds long, but, I mean, it's unreal. I just put a bunch on repeat, whatever. Anyway, and then we got Eric G, as usual, man. Normally, like, my favorite one to producer combination. Anyhow, he's going up here after we get off sides, unfortunately, because that could have been a big turning point in the game, but it wasn't. So he gets the ball right back. We are up 7 after going for 2 points on the touchdown that we were able to score after the turnover. So we're in pretty good shape here. Again, he's doing a good job, man. Definitely was staying good with under pressure. 4th and 5, he was able to convert. I think he had several 4th down conversions. And that's definitely key, man. If you're not a punter, like I'm not, you know, those 4th down, 4th and shorts, 4th and mediums are super imperative to be able to convert and not fold under the pressure. And he was doing a good job of that. He did have RG3, was rolling out quite a bit. And I don't know how, man. That was just a bad animation. We followed him. We were trying to lurk that pass, but didn't do good. And then he really did a great job there clicking on and getting that pick, man. That was a heck of an animation that he got there. So good stuff there. And I was just frustrated, man. If you guys could see, like, normally I'm underneath type passer. I don't really throw a lot of streaks and stuff like that. And I don't know, but this game, if he scored a touchdown, it was like literally the first play I was doing. I noticed when I was chopping up, I would literally just be like, all right, it's time to throw a streak. And that's not my, right there too, like I was scrambling. I should have just threw it away, man. And for some reason, I threw it back into the middle of the field and he intercepted it. So he's in the driver's seat now. 3 minutes to go, 2 minutes, 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Big third down here. We're sitting back. We see him running verticals or whatever that post play is there. Jack Ham again, user style right there. So that's great. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left. If we just get a couple first down, this game's over with. So we stay in underneath like we normally do. Just trying to eat up some of the clock, get a couple first downs, make him use his timeout. So there goes one of them, one of his timeouts. There goes another minute and 30 seconds. Hellington gets the big first down for us, man. Pretty much seals up the game right there. So now if we could just hold from fumbling, again, hopefully they'll integrate a dive button for the running backs so that they can just like take a knee without doing anything crazy. Anyway, we were able to kick the field goal. He has just enough time for one Hail Mary. But yeah, I'm hoping they can integrate like a dive button or something like where you could center yourself in the middle of the field and just down it out like that. But anyway, I'm Dreamkillers representing Mad Mastermind. Hit like if you guys enjoy. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram, man. And we will be back tomorrow with the two-a-days, man. Again, I appreciate the support from the bottom of my heart, man. It means a lot.